So here I'm already created a sample form, so I'm just fill some details over here. Let's give some message over here, and let's hit the submit button. So once the submit button hit, it's giving the nice alert message and it's removed after a few seconds, and the form is also resetted and our data is successfully stored in the Firebase real-time database. So watch this video till to the end and learn how to store your form data into real-time Firebase database. So without wasting your time, let's get started. I already created a simple contact form over here, so you can use your own desired contact form for your or create a form by yourself. So first of all, what you need to do is you need to log in to your Firebase account. So open the Google search engine and search for Firebase. Open it, firebase.google.com. So use your Gmail to sign in into your Firebase account. So this is the Firebase landing page. So once you reach over here, so click go to console. So all we need to do is just create a new project over here. So click new project, add project, and give a name for your project. So I just saved as contact form 2. So click continue. And by default, the Google Analytics, it's enabled for this project. So if I don't want, I'll just disable it and create project. So this might take few minutes. In the meanwhile, make sure that you use the proper ID name for all your input fields inside your form, and make sure that your button type is submit and give a proper name for your form. So now let's check, it's going to finish. Yeah, now it's finished. So click continue. So here we are going to use the real-time database. So click here, click the real-time database and click create database. So don't change anything over here. If you want to choose any nearby region for yourself, but you can change it, but I'll leave it as it is and click next. Okay, so here you have two modes, lock mode, test mode. If you're choosing test mode, it will enable or it will release all the kinds of functionalities like read, update, delete, everything as a true. But that's not secure when you're using a real-time cloud database. So choose the lock mode and I'll show you how to update your rules, security rules for your database. So choose the lock mode and click enable. Now the database is get created. Now nothing is there so far, it is returning null. Now click the rules. So by default, read, no one is supposed to read our data, so leave it as false. Write, let's make it as true. Okay, so this is not the highly secured rules, but this will okay for currently for this project. When you're working with real-time project, if you're having multiple forms, you need to configure for each and every form with the separate rules. So now this is done, and then do the same thing for your Firebase database, Firestore database. Create database, same, next, choose same, enable. So this will create a cloud Firestore for your database. So let's be patient. It will take few seconds or a few minutes to create your database, so please be patient until it's created. Once it's done, so click rules, do the same thing for here. So by default for read and write it's false, so let's change this. So delete, for read false, allow for write if true. Now it's done. So make sure for read false and write true. Once it's done, what you need to do is just click project overview. We need to create a web app. So click here to create a web app and name that app as your own project name, or give up some other name for your app. So I'll give it as contact form. Click here to register the app. So once it's done, you can, if you're using Node.js, you can install this Firebase and you can use this configuration settings for you for your project. But now we are going to use the script tag, so I'm just going to copy this. So if you want to use the script tag, you need the CDN link for your Firebase. I drop this link in the description box. You can check in the description box to use this CDN link. And then now this is our configuration, Firebase configuration. So just copy this from here, copy it, and inside your project create a new JavaScript file and paste it in the top of the project and save it. Okay, so once you created, you need to make sure that it's having the storage bucket and it's having the database URL. If you don't enable your Firestore and your real-time database while before creating your app, you will not have this storage bucket and your database URL. So first you need to create the real-time database and Firestore database. Once it's done, what you need to do is we need to initialize your Firebase app. So copy this line and Firebase dot initialize the app. Oops, not Firebase config, Firebase. So it's an object, it will come from your script file which we already included in our index.html file. So now what we need to do is we need to, so this is for initialize, let me zoom a little bit, yeah, initialize Firebase. Once it's done, we need to create a reference for your database. So reference your database over here. So now what we need to do is, so use the same object Firebase dot database, open the bracket, dot reference. So here you need to create a database name, so contact form. So this database is currently not in our real-time database. If you check over here, okay, so we don't have any database over here, nothing, it's literally none. So this will create the database and it will returns an object, so we need to catch that object. So const contact form db is equals, okay, so contact form db or db reference, create a reasonable object for that. So once it's done, what you need to do is we need to get the contact form from your HTML file. So this is my form, so I'll copy the ID and then I'll use document, so let's make it as a bad variable, document dot get element by ID. We are selecting the contact form and we are adding a listener event for this, add event listener, and that listener event is going to be submit. If the form gets submitted, we need to call a function submit form. So you should not call the function here, you should send the reference for your function which you created. Currently we not created the submit form. So if that form gets submitted, it will cause this submit function. And now let's create that function, function submit form, send an event into this, because we need to prevent the default event, because whenever you are pressing the submit button, this entire forms gets reloaded, so we should avoid that. So event dot prevent default. So this will prevent the default action of your form. So now what we need to do is we need to get the values of each and every single field which we have over here. So instead of repeating the same kind of like document.getElementById name, like we have three different fields, so I need to write the same line again and again. So I'll create a reusable code, like a function, use a functions to get the value. So const get element val value equals, I'll send the ID as a parameter to this function. Okay, so here let's return the value get document dot get element by ID, and we pass that ID and we'll fetch the value from that ID value. Okay, now we'll get the name from here. So variable first is the name, so equals what is the ID name, ID name, copy that ID name and call that function get element value and pass that ID name inside. So this function will returns the value of that particular element. Then variable email ID equals get element by value, we need to pass the email ID, email field ID, so that's email ID. And variable message content equals get element by value, we need to pass that message field ID, that's message content. So now let's cross verify whether it's getting all the values or not. So console.log we print the name, email, oops, email ID, comma message content. So if everything is working fine, now in the console we should get the field values like name, email, message content, all the fields values. So let's right click and inspect the elements and keep it in this side. Refresh. Okay, so Firebase it gets loaded. And now let's type some value. Summit. Bingo. So we have our name, we have our email, and we have our the message content. Everything is working fine so far. So now what we need to do is after this, we need to save the message to our Firebase. So now we have all the values in our hands, so we need to save this message to the Firebase. So let's create one more functions to save the detail. So const save messages equals, so this function need all these values, so I'll pass all these values as a parameter to this function. Name, email ID, message content, so this function takes three inputs as a parameter like name, email ID and message content. So now what we need to do is we need to push this all these value into our database. So let's create a new reference. So variable new contact form equals, we already created a reference for our DB, so we use that dot push. So after this, so new contact form dot set, now we need to set the value by using the set method. So this takes the object, so you need to send the key and the value. So key is going to be name and the value for this is name from our parameter. So email ID, email ID. So it's not necessary you need to use the same name for your parameter and for your key, it can be anything, but it should be reasonable so you can easily understand what value it carries on. So message content, well then message content. So that's it. So now this save message will push these values what we set in this object to your database contact form in your Firebase real-time database. So now we need to call this function, unless it will not work. So let's call this function. So save messages, and this function needs three inputs. So let's send the input name, email ID, comma message content. So now if you hit submit button, it will get this function will returns all the values from their respective fields, and we catch in their respective variable name, and we pass those variable name to the save message function. This function will create a new reference for your contact form and push the details what we set in this JavaScript object. Let's check it whether it's working fine or not. So name, and let's type some message and click submit. So nothing happened because we didn't have anything. So let's check it over. See here, now it receives, it creates the database and open it. We have an object, and here this is the message which I written in my form, and it successfully stored in my Firebase database. So now what we need to do is we just need to create a nice alert message, and we need to reset this form once the data is successfully inserted. So let's create an alert class. So this is an alert message, so let's make it more creative. So dot alert with 100% and background color, let's say green, and change this color somehow. Okay, so padding 10 pixels and 20 pixels, border radius 5 pixels, and then text align it in the center, and let's change the font size it's going to be 18 pixels, and font weight it's going to be 900. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so far this is good. So now by default display it's going to be none. Okay, because once the submit form is submitted, we need to make that alert message, we need to enable that alert message. So once this is done, we need to enable the alert. So now document dot get element by ID, or we can select this alert by using the class. So dot query selector. So make sure you need to add a dot because it's a CSS class. So dot alert, and this style dot display command, auto suggestions style dot display is equals block. Okay, so once this message is saved, so this alert message will be changed, it will change the display from none to block. So we'll get the display message over here. So let's check it out whether it's working fine or not. Again, testing sample message, hit it. Yep, so we are getting the alert message, and our data is also stored. See, testing sample message, it's under data is also stored. So now we need to remove it. Once the alert message, after 3 seconds, we need to remove that alert message. So let's remove the alert. So to remove the alert, again the same thing, call this. Okay, but instead of removing it instantly, we need to set an interval. So set timeout, use the timeout method. So inside this timeout method, we are going to change that style we are going to change that style to none. So change it to none and give the timeout like in milliseconds, like 3000 milliseconds. That means 3 seconds. So once it's done, it will remove that alert message after 3 seconds. After that, we need to reset the form also. Reset the form. To reset the form, what we need to do is we need to copy this ID, copy it, and there is a function, inbuilt function called reset. Let's use that function reset, so that will reset the function. Reset. So document.getElementById, this will reset the function. So let's have a go through here. So we configured our Firebase database configuration settings and everything, and we initialized the Firebase app, and we create a reference for our database called contact form. If this database is not available, it will create the database every time. And then we are getting our own form ID, and we are adding a listener event for our submit, a listener event called submit. Once that form is get submitted, it will call this function, and that function will get the value. So we are using is another function to get return the value from a specific ID. By the help of that function, we'll get every single element values, and then we are passing that values to the save function. So save function will create a new reference and push the values which we set into this JavaScript object. Once it's done, it will create, it will enables the alert message, and it with a certain timeout, it will displays that it will removes that alert message, and finally it will reset the form. So let's check out whether it's working fine or not. Again, testing alert message. So hit submit button, form is resetted, and then after 3 seconds our alert message is also removed. And let's check out whether the data is saved or not. And here we go, we have our message in our Firebase real-time database. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you love this video, share it with your friends and leave a comment and give a like for this video.